Hey everybody, it's Viv here, and I just need y'all to call the napkin police because I think I have gone overboard with napkins. I discovered this from Marianne at Pocketful of Vintage, and I have just let my imagination and ideas just flow in this direction. Well, where to start? Okay, I'm going to start off. Well, last week I showed you some projects that I made from it, from this napkin. And I still have plenty of napkins left. I love this design. It's very chic, shishi poo poo, French, shabby chic, and I love it. And this is a die cut that I have, and I did the front and the back, and I thought this would make some good covers for an album. So I did this. And then, let me see here. I did some buttons, and I have quite a few of these buttons elsewhere, but I just thought I'd show you those. That's not a really good place to show them. Let me see if I put it on something else here. You can see that a little bit better. And they're front, forward, and back. There's chipboard with the napkins on them. And I thought with crystal effects or something else, that a glossy accents or something like that, that would make them really shine. But I like them kind of matte finish there. So I did those. I have a whole thing of those. And still, like I said, I have plenty of napkins. Then I did these little tags. And the tags are, you know, I just love them. I just love them. I haven't done anything to them. I haven't distressed them or anything like that. I just think they're really, really cute. So, same napkins. And I guess that's the whole thing with scrapping. Because once you cut something out, you have little pieces left. And, you know, I find little dies that all that shape, and I cut some more stuff. Okay, so then in my class this year, we are doing Pride and Prejudice. They actually had to read the book. We saw different film versions, and they created plays or scenes based on the book, the original scenes based on the book. So one of the parts, activities that I have them do in order to get into character is write letters in character to another character. I don't know if that made any sense, but for example, Lizzie from Pride and Prejudice might write to her sister Jane, and there was a lot of letter writing in that particular movie and book, and so I created this, and the students will use this week. This is another napkin, and we're going to seal it with the wax, and when they'll write on the inside, and then we'll seal it with the wax, and we'll put labels on it and actually mail it to them, their houses and whatnot. Just something fun for them to get in the character. This one, as you can see, I put the Mod Podge on it, and it made it kind of glossy. It was a glossy Mod Podge, and I just love it. It's just cute. The napkin was cute too, and I'll show you that napkin a little bit later. And then I have this one, which is adorable, and they look like something that would be in Pride and Prejudice. And once again, this is where they'll actually put the letter. And this is an A2 envelope. I have this die, and they'll just write on here. And once again, we'll seal it here. And this too has the glossy finish for the Mod Podge. Okay. This one does not. This is another napkin, and this is what it looks like in full, and I just cut this out just a little while ago. So these, and I have a number of students, so I'll cut one out for everybody, and this is the last one, and they're all kind of different because they're different parts of the napkin. So this is what they look like. This is what the napkin looks like. Isn't that gorgeous? I love it. Ah, here's a button. Sorry. So that's what the napkin looks like if I'm not in the way. And I did quite a few of those. They look like paintings. It's so pretty. And okay, all of these are the same. I'm sorry. Let me just get to the next. Skip down to the next. And this is another napkin. So these are all ready for me to cut into the A2. Now, this is why I said I need the napkin police. I found these sort of on sale, and that they were good prices. These are like a dollar, and this is coming from the Christmas shop, and this was not a dollar. This was $1.79, I think, and this was at Tuesday morning, but I love the design, so, and this one, same company, was $1.79. Yeah. So, but I love that color and that design. These were the ones that were so pretty. They looked like a painting to me. And I think this is $1.29 that I got at the Christmas tree shop. And this one, gorgeous, just gorgeous. Same price. And this one. Okay, so all of them will have different letters to do. And I can't tell you what fun I had creating these. And I know the students will enjoy it. They're already talking about bringing in their pens, the calligraphy pens, and all sorts of stuff to have a good time. So I'm looking forward to that. Now this week, I challenged myself to do a couple of things. I wanted to make some cards, and I wanted to do some stick pens. And I'm hoping that I can put the two together, actually make some cards with some stick pens. So stay tuned, and hopefully I'll have another video with just that. All right, so y'all have a wonderful Saturday. I hope you had a great day, and keep creating.